Good evening, everyone. Oh, a crowd this big probably can sound a little bit stronger than that. Good evening, everyone. Oh, my goodness gracious. Sound like some rowdy Methodists. We're going to have a wonderful worship service here tonight in a variety of ways. Our Christmas Eve services always are just wonderfully attended and just a lot of fun, a lot of joy. We know that you've got family and friends with you. We're very excited that everybody is here with us to celebrate. Excellent, excellent, excellent. All righty. Well, our young men lighting our candles. They will be lighting the Advent wreath, and in a few moments we'll light the Christ candle. Let's go to the good Lord in prayer this evening. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the light of Christ, what that means to each and every one of us. We know that the reason for the season is you, Jesus. We know that your presence, your spirit is right here in this room. You are alive and well. We ask that you guide us in this, your worship service, and may everything we do over the next moments be pleasing in thy sight. We always give you the praise and glory, and may all of God's children say, amen and amen. Our tradition over the years was always to recognize Olin and Annabelle Dobbs. Now, they are both in heaven, but they always celebrated their wedding anniversary on Christmas Eve. So we would do something special in honor of them. And since they have went on to be with the Lord, over the years, we've also had a young family in our church that celebrate their birthday on Christmas Eve. Michael and Michaela. So we've asked them the last couple of years to put up two chrismons in honor of Olin and Annabelle and honor of their birthday as well. So can I embarrass Michael and Michaela again to come forward and do that for us? This one is for Annabelle. It's the prettier one, Michaela. If you will place that on the chrismon tree, Michael, if you'll do that for Olin. Now today is your birthday as well. You can't just throw it up there, Michaela. You just hang it up there. Okay. Way we used to throw those, you remember back years ago. Well, at this time, we're going to ask our little ones, Amy. She's going to do a song for us, some of our little ones.
Yeah.
We light the Christ candle tonight in honor of the Savior born to save the world. Emmanuel has come. And may all of God's children say, amen, amen and amen.
It came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their harps of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from hands all gracious King.
The gospel message comes tonight, and it'll be a devotion from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2, starting with verse 8. Hear the word of the Lord. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. For behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be for all people. For this is a sign born to you this day in the city of David, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign for you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And then suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." So it was when the angels had gone away from them into the heavens that the shepherds said one to another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning the child. And all those who heard it marveled at these things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told unto them. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. I wanted to take just a few moments before we have our candlelight service and emphasize a couple points in that beautiful passage of Scripture, which of course is the Christmas story. The idea that the angel comes and tells the folks to not be afraid. The heavenly hosts begin to praise God, to worship God, to love God. And it's interesting that even in the concept of Mary and Joseph, did they really understand who it was that they had in their hands? Next week, Sunday morning at 8 and 11, I noticed there's going to be a special music, Mary, Did You Know? And that is a wonderful celebration of trying to realize that the people trying to grasp in that day and age that this child that Mary had, who it really was. Now, the angel is the A of our ABCs this evening, trying to relay that message. The B is that the shepherds were to go to the barnyard. Now, that's where baby Jesus was born. Now, we know, dear friends, that that doesn't seem like a nice place, of course. But as I mentioned a couple weeks ago, if you were here on a Sunday morning, that the innkeeper did not have to turn them in to find a place even in the barnyard, in the manger scene. And yet there was some compassion. There was some goodness in him to at least find a place that would be warm for our Christ child to be born. Now, some of you were with us just a week ago. We did a blessing of the barnyard critters. And I asked Miss Rochelle if we could show a couple pictures up there. We took a doggy bowl and used it to bless the critters at Second Life Thrift Store. So you can see us having fun there. You can see the little critters that were coming forward. There was even a possum as well. There were some of them that were real big, real small. You can see there. Ah, look at that. A lot of these are the critters. Now see, there's hold right there for a minute. There's a problem there. I did not know until I got there that the tent was going to be for gators. Coach Jones put that up. I did not know he was going to do that, and what I'm about to do, actually, that's a doll there for a Georgia Bulldog standing in the gap for someone, as you can see. But honestly, the more I prayed about that, church, I got to thinking, if anybody needs to be blessed, those gators need a blessing. Amen, amen. All right, thank you, Rochelle. Now, the C of our ABCs, this is the last one, and I just wanted to share this before we have the passing out of our candles, is that Jesus is Christ. The babe in Bethlehem, as we know, grows up to be the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He is the Savior of the world. He is the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. He is the first and the last. He is everything. He is the Christ. The Christ. Now, some of you may have remembered a few years ago, there was a show that came out from a book written by C.S. Lewis, The Chronicles of Narnia. And some of you watched that, and the picture of Jesus, of God, was the Lion of Judah. So we got a picture there. You see that? Of Aslan. And if you're familiar with that story, Aslan had created the land of Narnia. And in that process, there was some evil that took place. There was a white witch, and that white witch caused some complications. As a matter of fact, she poisoned all of those that she could, and she actually turned them into stone. And so when Aslan comes back on the scene, which he's supposed to be the risen Savior, Christ the King, our Savior, he breathes on those stone images. And they come alive again. They are restored. Jesus Christ is alive and well. He is King of Kings. I know we live in a crazy world. I know that some of your lives probably are very crazy, but I want you to know Christ is alive and well. And He loves you and He cares for you and He gave His life on the old rugged cross for you. And all we have to do is receive Him into our lives. That's what Christmas, that's what the incarnation is all about. Can you all say amen? Pray with me. Lord Jesus, thank you again so much for the wonderful worship that we have experienced tonight. Guide us now as we have our closing worship, as we have our candles, and as we light the candles to represent the light of Christ that is in this room, that is in our heart, that is in our world today. In Jesus' name we pray. And may all of God's children say, Amen. Amen. That's a beautiful singing, my goodness gracious. We will now ask those that are coming forward to light the candles. We'll take it from the Christ candle. We're going to pass these down the aisle now. When it comes to you, if you will turn yours, if yours is not lit, to be, receive the light, turn it back over, and then your neighbor will light theirs. Heaven must look like.
Alleluia to our King, Christ the Savior is born. Christ the Savior is born.
If y'all can just gaze a minute around the sanctuary and look at these beautiful lights. They all represent the light of Jesus Christ. Receive this blessing in the name of Christ, our Lord and Savior, King of kings and Lord of lords, the great I am. Thank you, Jesus, for what you mean to each and every one of us. May this begin a new year that we can celebrate and teach and love others the wonderful goodness of your grace and your holiness. Blessings now, Lord Jesus, upon each and every one, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. And may all of God's children say,
Amen.
Amen. You may extinguish your candles and give 7 hugs before you leave tonight.